talking about the other day?
Man, oh my God.
The one with
he wouldn't want to leave you nor forsake you.
Man, I'm awful.
I know, I had to read into that after just to like feel it again.
I was so encouraged.
Hey, what y'all talking about?
Oh, our pastor is preaching about this word.
God will never leave you nor forsake you.
Y'all believe that?
Yeah.
Yeah.
What? Nah. I mean, how could y'all believe that though? I know, but I'm saying, like, have you ever heard God? I never seen God. I never touched God. I never felt God. I mean, how is it real? It's not even tangible.
It's all faith. It's faith. It goes beyond what's physical, man. It's God.
I don't know about all that. I mean, even this, though, like, I can't be in two places at once. So how can he be helping me if he's trying to help you?
Because he's God and you're not.
He's everywhere. He's with you, with me, with them.
Man, y'all don't make no sense, man.
Well, let's ask Mr. G. Hi, Mr. G.
Hey, how you guys doing?
Mr. G, I got a question.
Yeah.
Like, they're over here talking about church and stuff like that. They're talking about God will never, what, leave us?
That's true? Yeah.
Nah.
Yeah, in the word it says that God would never leave us nor forsake us. I believe the word, and it just goes on to say that he's with us all the time. He's an omnipresent God. That means he's with you, he's with Nazi, he's with Finley, he's with Mel, he's with Parm, he's with myself, and even Nat. All throughout the day. You don't believe that?
That's hard.
Okay, well, we're in art class, right?
Yeah.
I can prove it to you. You want me to show you?
Yeah.
All right, go ahead and go to our easels.
It was funny.
We're going to do a little picture drawing. What we got to understand is that God has been with us from the beginning of our time up until now. And he's continually with us. But we got to show that he's there. And I'm going to let you guys see that he is with you. So what I want you guys to draw is an abstract portrait, okay? Abstract picture of you from way back, as far as you can remember, of your life. Up until this very point, wherever it is that you're at right now. Go ahead and draw it. And then we're going to go ahead and we're going to explain it, and then I'll show you that God is always there.
Okay. We worship you this morning, Lord. We declare together that it's all about you. It's all about you, Jesus. The center of it all. Sing it. Jesus said, center of it all. Jesus said, the center of it all. From beginning to the end, it will always be, it's always been you, Jesus. Jesus, nothing
Cheers!
Jesus, be the center of your church. And every knee will bow, every tongue shall confess you, Jesus.
Amen.
I get him draw a picture of my whole life, so I just do an abstract picture of my heart. Yes, it looks different from, but I believe that God made me different. He put different trials in my life, so there's some parts of my heart that are smooth, straight, and really complete, like just all the things that I do. And it's cool because he has completed me in my life.
All right.
Portrait of how my life was and how it's like a bumpy road, and like, you know, you have your ups and downs, and you know there's gonna be clouds that are gonna block your view from seeing, you know, the sun and the waves. I realized throughout my whole life Jesus is like a bird who watches over himself.
Right. Yeah.
In life we all have that time period when you're just a huge mess and you can't see anything because it's so dark. And then that's where I was a couple years ago, and as I went on in life, I noticed that God was with me no matter what, and he was like a candle lit.
Amen.
All right, now.
Okay, well, in life, I found God, and then I was like all about it, first love, everything. But then after a while, I just figured I couldn't see him anymore, and it just got old. And I just thought he was never there for me. But then I realized he was always there through everything, and I just barely found him again. And now this is where I'm helping other people find him. All
right. Justin.
Like, I like to think that there's good and bad in life, and so like I picture life like two pockets. And this pocket right here is filled already. You know, I'm almost 20, so I'm like a lot of bad things or whatever. Now it's like just empty pocket, man. I don't even know what to put in it. And like that, I'm just trying to find who I am. You know. All right, let's
bring up our abstract team to the front. Although we may not see it, Jesus Christ is within each and every portrait that has been brought forth to us today. And what we got to understand is that there's some of us who say that, yeah, I see God. I see him within my life. But then there's some of us who say, well, I don't really see him. I don't know what you're talking about. But the reason is because our positioning of the portrait is not the way that God wants it to. Positioning is a key part in our understanding of who Christ is to us. And just knowing where he is within our lives. Because when you position it correctly, you will see that Jesus Christ is in your life. Now that we are positioned correctly, we just need to be put in our place. Together as one unit under Christ, being positioned the way God wants us to be, we come out with a full-on portrait of Jesus within our life.
Oh, amen.
And that's what we got to understand. That when we position ourselves correctly, when we let God take control of our life, I mean, even if you don't, God says that he will never leave you.
Amen.
Whether or not you are in Christ, or out of Christ, or you don't know who he is, or you do know who he is, Jesus Christ or God says that he will never leave you nor forsake you. So,
amen.